Now that is that, and a point really seems pretty scant reward for the entertainment these two put on, particularly in the second half. The second half that saw two penalties awarded, both conceded by Mudi Najjar, the second half substitute. Maresh on target with one of them from the spot, Oli Bozanic with the other. Ante Milicic's team had led 2-0 at the break. Tommy Orr and Adrian Mariappa with an own goal from Sushniar, the only response from the Mariners. And then that late, spectacular, special goal from Craig Noon. One of the strikes of the season, earning the Bulls a point. It's a draw that doesn't do much for either team, in truth. The Bulls do edge ahead of Adelaide to fifth. The Mariners stay where they are, and it is the first ever stalemate between these two. Quite some game, that. Central Coast Mariners 3, MacArthur 3. Well, terrific for the supporters, and a game that was lit up by two very special goals. Craig Noon in the 90th minute, the outside of the boot. And at the other end, in the first half, Tommy Orr's volley, which was a peach as well. Jason Cummings' involvement didn't stretch to a goal tonight, although he did win one of the penalties. Tommy Orr gets the congratulations from some of those Mariners staff that he worked alongside for that brilliant first half strike. And there's plenty to pick apart. And we'll start by getting some reaction from the players with Ben Homer. Ben.
Simon, yeah, got Nikolai Muller here. Nikolai, obviously disappointing not to take all 3 points, but how proud are you of the team's fight back?
Yeah, I think we fight good back second half, especially. Get the lead, and then, outstanding goal from Noon, and, yeah, that's quality.
What was the message from Nick Montgomery at halftime to yourself who came on?
No, he just said, put anything in what you get, and today you play next to Oli, so in the midfield, more defensive, and, yeah, I got it, and, I think it was a good game for me.
Just on the Mariners at the moment, obviously the games are coming thick and fast. What's the key when you've got so many matches in a short space of time?
Yeah, so I think that's football, and every player loves it. Not too much training, just game. And yeah, I personally love it.
Congrats, Nikolai, on the performance tonight, and good luck in the weeks ahead.
Thank you very much.
Thanks, Nikolai. There's Nikolai Muller. We've also got Adrian Mariappa coming across. Adrian. It might feel like a defeat after leading 2-0, but you grab that late goal to snatch a draw. What's the overriding emotion right now?
Obviously disappointed. I think if we're going 2-0 up, we should be seeing the game out. Obviously, it's a couple of good finishes as well from us. Obviously to grab a point in the end, but like I said, disappointing. So I feel, the last two games we've, we should have probably got more points on the board.
Ante Milicic, your coach, wasn't too happy with the penalty decisions. What did you make of them from on the park?
Yeah, from where I was, it just looked like a coming together. But obviously, when you slow it down on VAR, it's always going to look worse than it is. But referee's got to make a decision. He did. I feel like we shouldn't have put ourselves in that situation in the first place. That was more disappointing. So, yeah, we'll look at it, see where we can improve, and obviously look to the next game now.
And what did it mean to score your first goal in the A-League? Man, Simon Hill in commentary said it was your first goal in a league competition in about 9 years. So were you pretty proud to get on the score sheet?
Yeah, it just fell to me, and I just hit it as hard as I could, really. Thankfully went in, and obviously added to us getting a point today, so glad I could help the team.
Obviously, you've come back from playing in the CONCACAF World Cup qualifiers. Firstly, what does it mean to play for your nation, but also, I should ask, how's the body feeling after what's been a pretty busy month?
It was a lot of flying. I flew. It took probably about 30 hours in total to get back, and obviously had the game the next day. So tried to prepare as best as I could and make sure I was in the best condition. But it's always difficult flying long distance. But it's the greatest honour you can have in football is to represent your nation, especially in World Cup qualifiers. But obviously, like I said, just tried to get back in the best condition I could to help the team.
Adrian, thanks for being so good with your time post-match, and good luck over the coming weeks.
Thank you very much. Cheers, guys. Thank you.
Thanks, Adrian.
Nice one.
Oh, what a nice guy. An absolute star. Adrian Mariappa, the Jamaican international. It wasn't a quiet night in Gosford at all. 3-3 at the end of this clash between the Central Coast Mariners and the Bulls. We're off to a short break. We'll wrap it all up, and there's a lot to get through on the other side. Don't go anywhere. These Bulls are going to go nice in the future. World 9 in Gosford. And what a moment this was here. Jason Cummins, was it a pen? Was it not a pen? Mood in a jar, off the bench. Injected himself well and truly into the action. VAR intervened. Oli Bozanic, their captain, stepped up. Kapow. Put that in the back of the net. Nice pen there. It all really heated up in the second half for the Central Coast Mariners. Not much doing in the first half. They had to fight back from two goals down, and that they did indeed. So, Macca, lots of goals. Wasn't the 1-0. I just wanted to ask you about that again, just to rub it in that you were incorrect.
Kapow, goals everywhere.
what a clash in the end. It was awesome what took place.
Yeah, it was. Fantastic. First half was a bit of an arm wrestle, and we thought, oh, it looked like MacArthur were just going to cruise away. And then all of a sudden, that goal before half-time really changed the outlook for the Mariners, and I think the change at half-time really changed the game as well. And the second half was fantastic.
Second half, yeah, belonged to the Mariners. Let's take a look at the Isuzu Ute Alex Tobin Points leaderboard. I'm sure there are a couple of updates there. The 3-2-1s, Oli Bozanic, Nikolai Muller with the two. He really made quite the change when he came on in the second half. Nearly scored an opener within moments of him coming on. And Tommy Orr, a goal to remember. He broke his five-year goal drought. And with Georgia, I'll get you to kick it off, because it did start with an absolute worldie here from the Bulls. Tommy Orr popping up to break his goal drought.
Yeah, it's an absolute cracker. It was one that was going to be up for goal of the season for sure, only to be met later in the second half. But for me, it's not good enough defending from Central Coast Mariners. Far too much space on the edge of the box. Yes, he's hit it brilliantly, but he shouldn't really get that chance to start with. I think that we spoke about it at halftime. They're so worried about the tall players defending on those set pieces that they didn't even think about, you know, picking up pieces as they come off.
And at that stage, it looked like it was going to take a worldie, because there was nothing really happening at that stage. And then MacArthur step up, and as you say, again, a set piece. This time the delivery was good. Mariupa just dropped off the defensive line, came away from all those markers, and it fell to him nicely, and he puts it away. First goal in 9 years.
Yeah, it's a great strike, but for me, Jacob Farrell needs to clear that header as well. I think that, you know, he's gone to make contact. It's almost like he's closed his eyes before he's actually
his
hit
head
that one.
In his eyes on that one.
But he made up for it here.
Yeah, this was, I think, the turning point for the Mariners. If they went in at 2-0, I think it was going to be a really steep hill to climb. But they got this goal. It was one of the first times that Farrell actually got forward in the game and utilised that space in wide areas that MacArthur were affording them. And they get a little bit fortuitous with the deflections into the goal, but that was really what I think sparked the Mariners for their comeback into the second half.
For the own goal, you mean?
Yes. It's not an own goal. Yeah. It's Lorena's. I'm giving it to him.
Listen to
it. It's Marisha's second for the season too. And this was the most contentious part of the game, let's be honest. At first, we were all looking at the arms because there was a coming together of the arms, and just happened to look down and see that the feet, there was just a touch. Just as Cummings went to put his foot back down, he got clipped from behind. And I think that was just enough to set him off balance. And this is the one that Oli Bozanic was willing to take, puts it away with aplomb. And at that stage, I think we all thought the Mariners were the only ones who looked like they were going to go on and win the game.
Yeah, but I think all of this started, Nikolai Muller comes off the bench at half-time. He sets the pace when has within the first minute, that strike on goal hits the crossbar. You really got the sense that, you know, Central Coast Mariners weren't done. They were coming out to play. You get that first penalty, gets them back in the game. And then this second one, another one, clear contact. Yes, he's run across his line. And as a defender, he's not intentionally making contact there.
Yeah.
But the contact's there, and you've got to go in the favour of the attacker.
I think the fact that it was probably unintentional saved him from getting his second yellow card, and obviously would have been a red. As Oli Bozanic said there, Maresh was keen to get off the mark. He's had a goal taken off him early in the year as an own goal as well, so he was keen to get there, and he stood up, took it well. And I'll be honest, at this stage during the call, I thought the Mariners are just going to go on with it. And again, it's another absolute worldie of a strike.
This is just ridiculous.
This is going to be on highlight reels for years. Like, this is one of... I think, to me, that's one of the best strikes I've seen. It is fantastic. He holds his ground out wide. It's a lovely floated ball in front of him. But just look at the technique here. The volley with the outside of the foot into the far corner on that angle. That is unbelievable.
Pressure of the moment as well.
Yep.
You're down a goal and you need to pull out something special. If he mishits that, he gets absolutely
99% of the time it goes into the stand. But
he's absolutely slaughtered for trying to do it, but you score one.
He can take a bound.
He's a hero.
Craig Noone absolutely on fire, and Tommy Orr involved in that one as well. Let's take a look at the Neds level player of the match, and it was Nicolai Muller. Georgie, you spoke about him. He came off the bench. He almost injected something straight away, but he was busy, and it was great to see him back, Macca, isn't it? Because he's had a bit of an absence out, injury, COVID, the works, but he's making his way into this team slowly but surely and having an impact.
Yeah. And look, the fleeting moments we have seen him, you see the quality he does have. He just needs to get game time now and really get back to his best physical peak, and I'm sure we'll see more of that.
Worldies galore tonight from Tommy Orr and Craig Noone, and let's hear from one of the goal scorers, Tommy Orr, now.
Tommy, pardon the pun, it was an absolutely awesome goal. Just tell us what it's going through your mind as you're about to hit the volley.
Yeah, I mean, on the edge of the box, I think I always learned that you either hit it into Rosette or it goes in the top corner. And I think the last 50 I did went to Rosette, and this one happened to go in the top corner. So, yeah, I was obviously pretty happy with that.
It'd been about 5 years, I think, since you last scored. So was it sort of affecting you at all? Was it in the back of your mind at all?
Not really. I mean, yeah, I think I've been helping the teams I've been playing in and playing in different positions, maybe a bit more defensive than I was earlier in my career. So it's not really something that I think about, but nonetheless, it's always nice to score goals. So for sure, it's hopefully not the last one for the season.
Just a quick thought on the scoreline, obviously up 2-0, down 3-2, and then fight back to claim a point. How do you feel about that result?
Yeah, mixed feelings. I think obviously any time you're 2 goals up and you can see 3 goals, it's obviously going to be disappointing. But I think we showed a lot of character at the end, and fantastic goal from Noone, obviously, to claw us back. But yeah, we can't really dwell on it. We've got to play again Sunday, so we'll just pick ourselves up, recover, and look forward to that game.
Obviously, it's been a few matches now without a win in the A-League men's. How do you arrest that drop in momentum?
Yeah, I mean, we have a lot of faith in the ability of our squad, and it's a long season. And I think if you look at the results all across the league recently, it's obviously a very even league, and a lot of teams are beating everyone. So every week, you know, you're going in for a tough contest. And yeah, we don't really dwell on it, but we're confident in our squad that we can go back to winning ways.
Thanks, Tommy. Have you ever won a goal of the season at all?
Not sure. I think Noone pit me half an hour later anyway, so it's all good.
Yeah, it's probably fair enough. Thanks heaps for the chat. Good luck.
Cheers. Thanks, guys.
Thanks, Tommy.